Also, too, there's a lot of folks panicking, saying that because of all this new storm it just hit, with all the storms hitting America, this is the end times. But I would think it's a somewhat self-centered when we think about all the storms hitting America. And I mean, I know there's earthquakes and there's storms, but don't just jump the boat because we had four hurricanes saying it's the end of the world, guys. Look for more things than four hurricanes coming to the United States.
We're coming on the air to bring you up to date on what it appears now to be the deadliest mass shooting at a house of worship we have ever seen.
Now, the pastor and his wife were out of town today, but their 14-year-old daughter was there at church. She is among the dead.
Among the dead, the pastor's 14-year-old daughter. At some point, investigators are hoping to arrive at a motive for this senseless massacre. So far, if they have found one, they're not sharing it with the public.
I woke up today remembering a dream, November 6th, 2017. In a church office, I saw a pastor standing behind a desk. I had this dream before I knew about the deadly church shooting in Texas that happened yesterday. I believe this dream is related, though. I was in the office with the pastor, and it was clear that he did not want to talk to me. I was a little bit irritated with him. I wrote down a verse on a piece of paper, Revelation 13:18. And I put a big question mark with it. I asked the pastor if he knew this. He nodded his head with a frown. I asked him, "Are you ready for this?" He didn't want to say anything. I told him that he would not make the rapture if God were not his first love. I looked up at the ceiling and I saw a glass window in the shape of a rectangle. It was a narrow window. It allowed me to see the sun up in the sky. That reminded me of God. And so I did a quick prayer in the dream, asking the Lord to give me the words to tell this pastor. I also saw the glass breaking. But I looked back to the pastor and I resumed talking to him. I felt more compassion for him now. I told him God loved him, and because he loves him, he is warning him that he would not make the rapture if God were not his first love. And the pastor could not blame God for not warning him. This dream could apply to many pastors of churches all around the world. They might miss the rapture if they don't fulfill the greatest commandment. The greatest commandment that our Lord Jesus gave to us is that we should love the Lord our God with all our heart, with all our strength, with all our mind, and with all our soul. This is the greatest commandment. And another commandment that is like unto it is that we should love our neighbor as ourself. In the dream, I wrote down a Bible verse on a piece of paper, and I don't think that I consciously chose that verse, but I think the Holy Spirit chose it. Revelation 13:18.
Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast. For it is the number of a man, and his number is 666.
I take this as a confirmation that we are living in the last days. We are living in the time of the beast. We are living in the time when the beast will rise to power.
And tonight, as Texas steals with the worst mass shooting in its history.
Now more than ever, we need to stay close to our Lord Jesus Christ and make him our first love. Without him, we would perish, but with him, we shall be saved.